Woohoo. Perfect.
Which is really nice.
Yeah.
It has a little bit of a, like a, just a dash of menswear.
I like that about
me too.
I mean, I like anything that has a dash of menswear.
Yeah.
So,
just
I
enough.
Mean that way.
Just enough. Yeah.
So, with my clothes. To be and like the story behind Abby Foster.
Oh,
here.
Well, I started off right after I had my son. Mm-hmm. I sort of went through a crisis of like who I was and what I was doing. Cause,
don't we all?
Yeah, right. This is very normal. Everybody goes through this. But I was a dancer for 13 years and I was a singer for 8 and had been doing musical theater for like 5 or 6 years. Mm-hmm. So I had this whole idea that that's where my life was going. Mm. There was no question that it was always going to be something artistic. Mm-hmm. Even when I was like 3 years old, my entire family was like, she's going to be some type of artist. and then after I had my son, I did not in any way see how I could mesh those two worlds together and have mm-hmm. it be what I wanted it to be. Because mm-hmm. I was like, I want to spend time with my son and doing musical theater, there's no time to yeah. bring him into that world or musical theater. It just wasn't going to
yeah,
work.
Absolutely.
And I remember at one point, I think he was a month and a half old, and he was napping, and I was literally sitting watching him nap because I had no idea what to do. I just was like, I didn't know how to express myself I had no creative outlet. Mm-hmm. And my mother, who knits and quilts occasionally, she had an old sewing machine. Mm-hmm. She said, here's a sewing pattern and here's fabric. Why don't you try making something? And mm-hmm. she showed me how to thread a sewing machine. And I made the ugliest dress ever. It was so bad. It was terrible. It was embarrassingly terrible. I didn't even show my mom. So what did you make? I said, nothing. It's nothing. I didn't. It's fine. And I remember putting it on, and I was so confused because I thought to myself, you have all the tools.
Yeah.
You have the pattern, you have the fabric, you have rulers, tape measures, you have a sewing machine. Why is it not the way that you want it to be? Mm-hmm. And I just kind of became fascinated with the idea of making something. Mm-hmm. And I think a week after that, I went to like Joann Fabrics mm-hmm. and bought a bunch of easy patterns and like sail fabric, mm-hmm. hideous sail fabric. And I just started sewing and I became sort of like obsessed with creating patterns. And after I got to the point where I was making my entire wardrobe and my son's entire wardrobe and lots of clothes for other members of my family. And I finally said, you know what, I'm not finding the styles that I want in the world of sewing patterns.
Yeah.
And so I bought a couple textbooks.
Oh.
And literally threw out all my sewing patterns and like packed the rest of them away. And I just said, you have to make your own patterns. And I made a dress. I think after a month after I had these textbooks, I made a dress and I showed it to my mom. And she said, oh, I paid money for that.
Whoa.
And I was like,
that's a big moment.
Yes. I said, wait a minute, and then I started thinking about, you know, I could monetize something mm-hmm. that I love doing and mm-hmm. I could do it under my own roof mm-hmm. with my son right there. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh, this is just perfect. This is exactly what I want to do. So, here, on your couch.
Well, and we met through mutual friends mm-hmm. and you showed up at, it was this last June.
Yeah.
May. And right. We sat next to each other at the mm-hmm. dinner, and we never met.
No.
We followed each other on Instagram.
Yeah.
But I just remember, we instantly clicked, mm-hmm. and we talked, the whole dinner, pretty much.
Yeah.
And it was awesome, and I was like, oh my gosh, Abby's so cool. I'm so glad I sat next to her, and since then, we've become friends, and it's been really cool, and now we get to do this together, and mm-hmm. I just love that how people come into each other's lives and mm-hmm. how it works that way, and so.
Yeah, and I feel like you and I have a similar vision in the sense that we know what we want, mm-hmm. and we both have, a very specific aesthetic mm-hmm. to what we want, mm-hmm. and a lot of what we like coincides, which
yes.
is so wonderful.
And it makes it very easy.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
So, yeah. Or else that would be a challenge, but yes. No, it does make it really easy. And I remember because I was wearing that, like, tunic.
Mm-hmm.
That is so cool.
I love that. That I know. Was really cool.
So maybe we just need to make our own version sometime. Yes. But I also would just love to hear, like, your thoughts on clothing and... Because I know you're super passionate about it.
Yeah.
And,
that's a lot,
like,
of opinions.
Why you choose certain things and everything. Because I love hearing about it, one. And two, I think it's really interesting in this day and age of, like, fast fashion mm-hmm. and everything. And to think about buying pieces that really last and, like, do something in your wardrobe. And then being, like, not just necessarily pieces of art, but things that can live with you.
Mm-hmm.
Is, like, so... incredible to think about. And so
I agree.
So go.
I agree.
Give us your thoughts.
Well, when I had started sewing and I was doing sewing patterns, a lot of it was like very loud prints, mm-hmm. like vintage retro styles, because I love
mm-hmm.
I love retro clothing and vintage clothing. But I got to a point, I think it was probably 2.5 years, when I sort of looked at my closet, like after I started sewing mm-hmm. for myself, and I had no basics. Everything was like loud and like just so many patterns mm-hmm. and it was nothing that was practical that I reached for on an everyday basis.
Mm-hmm.
And so when I had then started creating my own patterns and I made my first dress that I was like, this is mine, mm-hmm. entirely built by myself. And I sort of looked at it and I thought, you know, maybe this is an opportunity if I want to make clothes to kind of help make those foundational pieces that I feel like people would reach for every day.
Mm-hmm.
And when I first started looking at fabrics and sourcing fabrics, I got terrible fabrics. And like everything was blended with polyester or, mm-hmm. you know, cotton blends. It was mm-hmm. because I was so worried, I was thinking to myself, oh, this is going to be a really big, you know, financial investment.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember sitting down with my mom. And I said, what do you think of these fabrics? And she said, you know, if you're going to do linen, do linen. Mm-hmm. If you're going to do cotton, do cotton. Mm-hmm. Like, don't bring in anything extra.
Mm-hmm.
And so that kind of hit me. And I went back to the drawing board and I said, you know, why is linen so expensive?
Mm-hmm.
Why is organic cotton so expensive?
Mm-hmm.
Why are, you know... these certain brands that sell these like higher quality fabrics and mm-hmm. like, why are they so expensive?
Yeah.
Why would people spend, you know, $250 for a pair of pants?
Mm-hmm.
What is so special about them?
Yeah.
And so, you know, going through that, and I did like the whole, I condoed my own closet and I was looking at, you know, I had this black wool skirt that I still have it. My mom bought it for me when I was 13 years old. And I was like, I still have the skirt. Why did it last so long? And I sort of had this epiphany where I was like, you need to design clothes that are never going to go out of style.
Yeah.
You need to use fabrics that can withstand anybody's lifestyle.
Yes.
And that way, you know, there's nothing worse, I think, than buying something that's really trendy
mm-hmm.
and then seeing someone else wear it 3 months after it's done mm-hmm. being trendy. I think it adds age. I think mm-hmm. it adds weight half the time. Mm-hmm. It's not practical.
Yeah.
And so I am trying to, you know, build a brand that offers women clothing that you always can rely on,
mm-hmm.
that you can just get up and say, I literally have to run out the door. This is like a dress or a mm-hmm. pair of pants or a top, whatever it may be, that will always withstand whatever I'm doing.
Yes.
And so that's sort of my philosophy on things, I guess.
Well, and I think I've kind of done that over the years, whether I knew it or not, like mm-hmm. with my own clothing, where it was like, I don't want to think about what I'm putting on every day, mm-hmm. really. Like, I want to be able to just, like, look at my closet and be like,
I can grab that, like, yeah. blindly almost, and
yes.
grab stuff
and
put
it
on. And
it's gonna work.
Yeah, but you still want it, and that's the,
But you want to look good.
Exactly. It has to hit at that intersection of, like, comfort, utility, and style,
mm-hmm.
because, I mean, there are a lot of, like, brands out there that are offering, you know, clothes that are just like they're modern and they're utility and
mm-hmm.
it's perfect.
Yeah.
But there's no femininity in it. There's no
mm-hmm.
style. And so I feel like you can kind of have all of that in one.
Yes.
which is what I'm trying to do.
Yeah, no, it's and you are. It's like, you are.
That's coming across. Yes.
Well, and because my whole thing is, like, I'm normally the most comfortable in a pair of jeans mm-hmm. and a t-shirt, really. Mm-hmm. Like, that's, like, go-to every day. But, you know, if I, like, for instance, I'm going to a wedding, mm-hmm. like, what do I wear and how do I have something that will stand the test of time? Mm-hmm. That if I buy it, it's not something I'm just going to be done with after the wedding.
Exactly. And exactly. No, I agree. And I try to do at least one closet purge a year mm-hmm. because, like, I'll always end up finding myself, like I had some, like, old red linen shirt I made for myself mm-hmm. and I was like, I don't even wear this anymore. This yeah. is, why is this in my closet? But I've always tried to tell myself, like, do a 90 to 10, which is mm-hmm. 90% of your closet you should be mm-hmm. able to wear every day. Mm-hmm. Even if it's a dress, make it one that you can wear when you're working or if mm-hmm. you're going to the beach or you're going to a wedding. Mm-hmm. And only let 10% of your closet be those, you know, that sequin dress that you absolutely love and you never want to part with. Like, let only 10% of your wardrobe be pieces that you can't wear every day. Because otherwise, I feel like it just... It's difficult then to pair everything with each other.
Oh, totally.
Because you can't do that if you have all these special pieces.
Yeah.
Especially, you know, if they're you have a certain percentage of your wardrobe maybe you can only wear in the fall and the winter. And that will always happen.
Yeah.
You're not going to wear your wool sweater in August in Northern Michigan. But pants?
Yeah.
You should still be able to get away with that.
Yeah. Yeah. And honestly, I use the same rule when we designed our house. It was 90% classic with, like, a neutral palette mm-hmm. mixed with, like, 10% of things that felt, you know, kind of trendy or...
Yeah, because then you can always, you know, swap out things that you like. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, I'm not a big fan of trends, but there are occasionally some aspects of them. I'm like, bell sleeves. I could do bell sleeves.
That'd be
and
fun.
It's like, and so it's like I give myself that little bit of extra space. Mm-hmm. But I can only do that because I know that the rest of my closet is filled with stuff that can hold up to a trend. Yeah. It's not going to just be like, well, now I gotta get new pants to go with that bell sleeve top that I want.
Yeah.
Like, no, I already have classic pants that I can pair with them, and I think it's so much easier getting dressed.
It is.
If you have that layout already.
Yeah, and being a mom, like, you don't want to look like you just gave up, but you don't want to look like...
And I want to be able to, like, wake up and pull something out of my closet and walk out the door and then not halfway through the day be like, what did I put on? Like, I want to be able to be like, okay, I look classic, mm-hmm. put together. It's flattering for the mm-hmm. most part on my body mm-hmm. and for my hair and my skin color. Mm-hmm. It's like, you know.
And you're comfortable.
Yes. It was just such a big part.
Huge part. Yeah. And warm.
What I've noticed with the majority of brands that I have liked for a really long time. Mm-hmm. As time goes on, I feel like fabric's getting more or less and less substantial.
Mm-hmm. Whereas, I agree with that.
My point of view, I mean,
especially
I
for women's
clothing. Yeah, I want, like, I don't want to put on some top and, you know, in November and it's just blowing with the wind.
Yeah.
Like, I'd rather have something that's going to keep me warm. It can still be fashionable mm-hmm. and it can still be, you know, classic. But I just feel like we've lost that substance of like those fibers, like those heavier weights that we should be investing in.
Like, we kind of designed this jacket to be more of a, like, easy piece that you can carry through every season, right?
Mm-hmm.
So let's talk about that.
Well, you had mentioned you had a jacket that was sort of, that you wore all the time, that you would throw on, and we went over sort of the pros and cons, what you liked and what you didn't like. Mm-hmm. And I sort of had this idea to do something that was slightly Parisian, mm-hmm. that would fit in well with, like, a farmer's market vibe, but just something that could be thrown on over whatever you have during the spring and summer or year round. You could kind of wear it whenever. And it would just sort of act almost as like a house coat, but not an actual house coat. Like, not something that's terrible, but something that's sort of has a utility look to it. Mm-hmm. So,
I'm super excited about it because the one I have is, like, heavier weight, mm-hmm. and which is great, but to have something through the spring and summer that I can just, like, toss on.
Yeah, and I think it'll be, it's it's one of my favorite weights of linen. Mm-hmm. So it's something that is going to feel substantial enough in like those colder months to wear around inside. Yeah. But it's also going to breathe well enough for spring and summer.
Yes.
Which is good.
Which, you and I both have the same mentality about clothes. In yes. the sense that, like, we both yes. connect with, like, a more... We want pieces that are just going to wear, like, iron. Mm-hmm. One. And
yes.
two, we also want something that feels feminine, yet structured mm-hmm. and strong.
Yeah.
So, this is kind of one of those pieces, but... That's kind of why I think it naturally fit for us to work together.
Mm-hmm. I completely agree. I destroy my clothes. And so when I design, or even if I'm looking to buy something, I want to make sure it's in a fiber mm-hmm. that is going to withstand the cold and then the heat, mm-hmm. and it can be washed. And it's just a workhorse fabric that's not going to just tear or shrink, which is why I love linen so much. Mm-hmm. Linen is a workhorse fabric.
It is.
Especially in this weight, too. So it's something that's like, it's just going to feel substantial, and it's going to feel stylish, and it's going to feel like you can wear it if you're gardening, but you mm-hmm. can wear it out for drinks. And that's really important to me, is mm-hmm. having something that can be a part of all those different facets of life.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I think the beauty of linen is, well, so many people don't, I know I used to be this way, like where I would like steer away from linen.
Because it wrinkles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so,
and you can't dry it, or you shouldn't dry it.
Yeah.
No, definitely.
But I have learned to just love linen for the mm-hmm. fact that it just holds up to everything. Like,
oh, yeah.
other than putting it in the dryer, obviously.
Yes.
But it just, it fits in every situation. You can wear it to a wedding. You can wear it to sleep in. You can, like, mm-hmm. it's not, and the fact that it's made out of a plant that is completely mm-hmm. sustainable and renewable and like doesn't require much of anything to grow.
Yeah. No,
so,
that's
versus
linen
cotton,
is magical. Yeah.
That needs so much pesticides and only can be harvested
yeah.
one time.
Exactly. And cotton seems to just I love cotton, certain types of cotton.
Yeah, I do too.
And certain weaves.
Yeah.
But most cotton, I feel like just it soaks up everything from
mm-hmm.
you. Whereas linen, I feel like, just is sort of that light shield between you and
mm-hmm.
the air and
yes.
the weather and everything. So I just feel like it breathes so nicely.
It does. It really does. And that's why I'm so excited about this. And to do more, because we're
yes.
also going to have the collection in the summer
mm-hmm.
and one in the fall. So
yes.
there's many pieces to come.
Yes.
And so it's really exciting. But okay, so let's talk about how...